There's always joy in watching a skilled craftsperson at work or an athlete at the top of their game. And as you watch an artist putting the finishing touches to a painting or a dancer finishing a beautiful routine, it always seems like they make it look so easy. But in a way, we're actually all top athletes. The champion of making things look easy is actually the human brain.
Even seemingly trivial tasks, such as making breakfast, require really complex cognitive mechanisms. Let's take a look. It's 7:30 a.m. You're in the kitchen, perhaps sleepily wishing you were still in bed. You pop a couple of slices of bread in the toaster, switch on the kettle, and open up the fridge door to find some jam.
You probably did most of these things without giving it much thought. But actually, there's an entire cognitive orchestra at work inside your head. And each section of this orchestra, whether it be attention, memory, or motor control, must work in harmony for such behavior to be carried out successfully.
So let's take a look at these steps again. Here, your attention system, that's the system that's responsible for making sure you don't miss out on anything important, must coordinate with your memories. Memories of where the toaster is located in the kitchen, your memories of how long the bread usually needs in the toaster, and memories of what the toast is likely to look like when it pops out. All work together in order for you to execute an action and retrieve the toast from the toaster.
Next, you raid the fridge. Here, your attention system is used to guide the visual search for the jam, carefully avoiding distractors that might look similar, for example, a jar of salsa, or hold some intrinsic value to us, such as a delicious cake. Our attention will be guided by our memories of where the jam was last time or where the jam is usually. Once we find the toast, we must once again coordinate an action to pick it up.
When there's a problem with just one of these components, the music falters. An action which previously seemed simple becomes a challenge. This is what we see in certain neurological conditions such as Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. As researchers at Oxford University's Department of Experimental Psychology, we aim to better understand this cognitive orchestra. In particular, how our past experiences guide our everyday behavior. We do this in three main ways: using virtual reality, or VR, computer-based tasks, or brain imaging.
My research focuses on how we coordinate attention, memory, and our actions to efficiently complete all these complex tasks in our everyday lives. Particularly, using virtual reality allows us to do justice to the often underappreciated complexity of our everyday tasks. By creating a VR environment with different scenarios and examining someone's behavior, we can really study how this complex cognitive orchestra coordinates when you are searching for your keys or putting together your new furniture. We usually take this coordination for granted while actually doing the task, but realize how difficult it is to achieve when trying to develop artificial intelligence systems to complete these same tasks.
Alternatively, we can use computer-based tasks together with brain imaging in order to carefully isolate and understand different cognitive mechanisms at play. For example, using a highly controlled task in which participants were asked to remember an item for a short period of time, we investigated how and when the brain begins to prepare for actions guided by our memories. We were surprised to find out that the brain almost immediately encodes future action plans. This is even the case when we know that we will have to carry out a series of actions in the meantime. This means as soon as you place the bread in the toaster and turn away to continue your breakfast routine, your brain is already planning the action of retrieving the toast from the toaster.
By better understanding how the brain coordinates attention and memory, we can pave the way for new and improved treatments of neurological conditions, and we can contribute to new developments in the field of artificial intelligence.